This is the red walker vine here at the horticulture farm. Gives you some idea of what the clusters look like. This is getting really close to when we would be harvesting these. This is our high-end spray program, which is probably what's going to be necessary for these grapes. After all, we're finally getting in some downy mildew at the end of the season here. But these vines are pretty clean. You can see these clusters are pretty clean. Starting to get a little bit of rot showing up, but overall they've done really well up to this point, especially with the kind of sprays we've been putting out by hand, and the vines look good. Very high quality fruit as far as I can tell just looking at it, and so it'd be something worth trying for sure in Georgia. I think it's very similar to a vinifera grape, standard vinifera grape. And again, if you put it out with a full spray program, similar to what you do with a vinifera grape, I think this is what you'd get. And so again, this is Pierce's disease resistant, very, very similar to what you would expect with any vinifera grape of this nature. These vines are immediately adjacent to the ones we're just looking at. Again, this is the California red variety, the Pierce's disease resistant walker vines. You can see the downy mildew has finally caught up with us. We've had downy mildew in the white variety for a long period of time, but you can see how the leaves are falling off. Lots of clusters, starting to get a little bit of rot in these now at this point. They've been hanging for so long, but nonetheless, it gives you some idea of the production. And unfortunately, with the downy mildew that we're now seeing coming in here, as you can see on these leaves, you can see all that downy mildew is really starting to affect these leaves. This is not something you want to see at the end of the season, so a full spray program would be required. So this is the white California variety with the Pierce's disease resistance. These have been hanging a little bit longer than you'd probably want them to hang now, but the leaves look good with a full spray program. Gives you some idea of the clusters still that are there. Get some feel for what those look like. Again, this would require a very nice full program for sure. It's much more susceptible than the red variety to downy mildew based on what we've been seeing for a while. I'll go across here. This is an untreated vine where we did not treat with anything. You can see the amount of damage from the leaves, clusters hanging, and just a lot of rot coming in on these clusters. That is predominantly bitter rot. And then we also do have some other rots thrown in there as well. But bitter rot is one of the ones we're seeing the most of in this particular site. There is macrophoma rot as well that is involved in this. Those are the two ones that we've been able to actually identify. And so this is what we're starting to see on the untreated. But again, with a full program, if you go down here to these vines that are sprayed for the season, you see we still have a good bit of nice fruit. And when you consider the amount of damage that's been done by downy mildew around these, we've done a good job of controlling it with the spray program.